up in front, as you can see, entire areas, entire part of the township, completely underwater. And this is exactly what the assessment is all about. Where exactly do they need to drop the food packets? Where exactly do they need to pull out people from? Where are the people who are submerged, whose houses are submerged, unable to come out? This is about 4 minutes of flying from the Tambaram Air Base. As you can see, still entire vehicles underwater, entire areas completely inundated, houses underwater. And this is a situation of the Chennai Airport, as you can see, completely underwater. The assessments are that it will take another 2 to 3 days before the airport starts functioning. As you can see, planes, aircraft still docked in their bays, but the runway completely and totally submerged. No operations taking place from here. The water still hasn't receded. It's about quite high, about 4 to 6 feet high in some areas. There you can see remnants of the runway still that is visible above the water. Water slowly receding, a long way before the airport can be made functional again. About 700 to 800 people still stuck in this airport. The Indian Air Force trying to build an air bridge that is to pick up people from here, land smaller aircrafts, helicopters from here, and take them to either Tambaram or Arnakulam, where the bigger Air Force transport aircrafts are there, and from there take them either to Delhi, Hyderabad, or towards Bangalore. And as we look at the residential areas, the areas next to the airport, there you can see the amount of water that is still there. Waterlogged buildings out there. We cannot yet see anybody on their rooftops, but I'm told little distance ahead there are some people who are still stuck, and the Air Force will launch sorties later in the day, and so will the Army. Using their boats, so will the NDRF using their boats, and the Navy try to get people out of these areas. A boat being used to take out people from the, as you can see, boats. We cannot make out whose boats those are, mostly of the state government, are being used to take out people from these areas. These areas completely waterlogged, as you can see. The highways, also the roads, somewhat blocked. People trying somehow to get out, as you can see, lines of people trying to negotiate that patch that seems to have been completely washed away. Meanwhile, a very strong current of water flowing through Chennai, part of Chennai more or less, this is that is there. As you can see, the water levels, how high they are, up to, you know, 2 stories high in these areas, in some of these areas, the water level is. According to state government assessments, the damage is huge, and it is only after the water levels recede that there will be some kind of a figure that will be put to the kind or the amount.